Hello guys, today we continue Apollo Justice Ace Attorney. So in the last video, we in the part where Darren try to find the Interpol ID number for us while we try to solve the mystery in this case. Now we will load one. Huh? Me? Pachi Tobaya pretended that he was blind. Do you know why? How could he know? Wait, Prosecutor Gavin knows why, doesn't he? Of course he knows, that's why he has. He's known from the start of the trial. He's been leading us on the whole time. Something's wrong? Do you think perhaps this is some kind of game? Know that the moment I hear the report, I knew why. I suppose people who have sold over a million records really are something else. What do they have to do with anything? There was a reason why Machi Tobai pretended he was blind. Save 8. But it wasn't for his own sake, getting the picture now. It wasn't for himself. Well, Mr. Justice, can you present evidence that shows why the defendant had to feign blindness? Show evidence that she had no reason to pretend he couldn't see? Which means, no, it couldn't be. Let's show your forehead. It seems you thought of something else. Why can't I figure out this thing out on my own? I hate having to take my cues from this guy. Very well, look at this. This is why he was pretending he couldn't see. Here for help, I'm disappointed in you. Unless you're merely feigning stupidity, ja? Keep it up, voice guy. Recall the relationship of Rami Lawyer and Machi Tobaya. In particular, their arrangement over the years before visiting our country. Rami Lawyer and her pianist. They would always walk together, she's leading him by the hand. Even when they got on stage, she would lead him to the piano. She would walk all the way over there with him. That's right, because he was blind, or so we thought. She led him all the times. All times. All times? Yet we know now that Machi could see perfectly well. I keep up the charade. Well, wasn't it part of their performance? There is a simpler explanation here, Judge. Machi did not need to be led by the end at all. Which means... you don't mean... I do. It was the other way around. The one who needed to be led by the end was Rami Lawyer. What? What's this? So you mean that Rami Lawyer she's blind as bad here, Judge? What? What? Order! 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 This is crazy, Prosecutor Gavin! Yeah, wasn't he supposed to be the landscape painter in The Sound of Something? Well, since we have her here, why not ask Rami Lawyer herself? I believe she is still in the witness waiting room. Apollo, what does this mean for our case? Don't ask me, I had no idea she couldn't see. I haven't even imagined it until now. Bailiff, bring in Rami Lawyer. Rami Lawyer, it pains me deeply to call you before us again in this way. And yet I must. Please, do not be concerned on my behalf. Those eyes. She really can see? Really? It is true. Wah! How funny it is that a tiny lay born in the Borginian countryside would one day grow to entangle the entire world. So you are... Yes, as I mentioned before, I have no memory of the time before I became Lamiroir. Know too that my memories begin in darkness. Save. The word light has no meaning for Lamiroir. I see. You may recall me saying something toward the beginning of this trial here forehead. What's that? Oh, yeah. I believe I said it was unfortunate this crime had no direct witnesses. Now, Lamiroir, I must ask you to stand once more. Can you testify to the court about your eyes? Of course. It was never my intent to deceive any of you. May I begin, Your Honor? Yes, of course. Though I admit I'm a little lost here. I think we are a bit lost here, Your Honor. Save 1. I have no memory of the light. I debuted in a world of darkness and sound. My procedure came up with my PR line before he knew this. So silly as it might sound, I had to pretend I could see. Everyone on my staff knew, of course, but no others. But this is a murder trial. I apologize. It was part of my contract, you see. I was to keep my blindness a secret no matter what. Music is everything for me. Imagine something like this world. She told us the truth in the beginning, when she said she saw nothing. Very well. Does the defense have anything to add? Save 2. I do like to cross-examination, but what is there left to ask? There was one thing in her testimony that bothers me. Perhaps it is best we let you get it out of your system. Someday you come to understand the importance of thinking for yourself. Very well, the defense may proceed. However, be aware this court not tolerate any question deemed too stressful to the witness. Okay. There was only one part that bothered me. Just let me ask about that and I'd be happy. Ooh. Save 1. I think this maybe. Perhaps your music reminded him of the Borginian scenery? No, it was quite the opposite. The opposite. According to my producer, my music has a certain global quality. Global? Multicultural, if you will. Hard to pin in on one region. When people listen to it, they picture the country closest to their hearts. Which is why my music has reached so many. What a lovely story! It sounds like this producer might have known what he was doing after all. My songs are nothing more than a white canvas. To me, the real landscape painter are the listeners. When I think of that, I do not mind how I represented to the world so much. Yet one thing quickly led to another. Yes, in 3. Press. Was that to protect your image as the landscape painter in the sound? That does not matter so much to me, really. But the label is quite concerned about it, I think. Landscape painter who can see? That's like a pianist who can play, huh? I'm not sure you can compare your father to Lamiroir. The world of commercial music is filled with these little white lies. Nothing is sacred when it comes to publicity. Save 3. Terus, when you say your staff, do you include Mr. Littles? Of course, he was my manager. So he knew, and that's what's been bugging me. Something's the matter, Mr. Justice? I believe I know what it is bothering our young defense attorney. You are thinking of when you discovered the body, yes? Is he right, Apollo? Yes, I was. Okay, I'm not gonna read this because I already read this many times. Mr. Littles told me to ask the witness, and he named you. Why would he do that? He knew you were blind. I don't know. Save 3. What did I just say? You need to learn to think for yourself. Meaning what? There is no mystery here if you recall everything he said. Think of his last word on the witness. Siren? He heard them names many times, playing with a little play-acting by our defense. I remember them well myself, but that statement is not to what I refer. I mean what he said before that. Before? What came before that? That's right, he tried to tell you. When he said can't see, he wasn't talking about himself. He was talking about the witness. I see. Too bad the defense did not. Well, here for head. Try relaxing and looking at the facts first next time. Yeah. Order! Recall Tommy Royer's earlier testimony? I was on my way from the backstage to the backstage exit. There were two shots. I couldn't do anything to stop it. But you can have heard those gunshots. I thought we'll prove that. That is not the most important point here. The moment he was shot, Mr. Littles witnessed her through that window. Why else would he have named her as the witness? But I really did hear them. Two gunshots and the man's voice. Unfortunately, such a thing was impossible. The window was closed. We have already run a simulation, of course. But it was so clear. If I hear that voice again, I will know it in an instant. Your Honor! What is it, Bailiff? Can't you see we're in session here? Save 3. We have the result back from the investigation. The investigation? The Interpol number that Mr. Littles left us. Nice! Well, let's hear it. We'll continue this crux examination afterward. Detective Kresken, your report, please. I asked Interpol about that number. I'm sure you find their answer intriguing. Quick work as always, Dayden. Well, tell us about the number. Is the defendant a secret agent? I'm not gonna read that. The defendant agent registered under was Roman Littles. What? Our undercover Interpol agent was Mr. Littles himself. He was apparently in the middle of an operation. So when he wrote those letters, he was trying to tell us his own identity, and a caution killer tried to wipe them away. Mr. Littles was an undercover Interpol agent? So him being Lamiro's manager was just a cover, most likely. There's one another important detail I found. Well, out with it. It concerned that 45 caliber revolver, the murder weapon. Apparently, it belonged to Roman Littles. Safe 3. He had an Interpol permit to carry firearms.